It's now time to head into the chat room, and joining us today is Nine's Davina Smith and Your Money's Chris Kohler in Sydney. Good afternoon to you both.
Chris, Sophie.
Afternoon.
First up, the arrest of Australian citizen Julian Assange after the Ecuadorian embassy withdrew its protection of the WikiLeaks founder. That will enable the US to start extradition proceedings so he can face charges for leaking hundreds of thousands of classified documents. Davina, first to you. This morning, Scott Morrison has said the government won't be assisting him. He's made his bed. Do you agree?
I feel that maybe Scott Morrison's got it right for the time being. I don't know how to feel about this, and I think a lot of Australians are the same. Like, on one hand, he's an Aussie, you feel like you want to protect him, but if he's broken the law, as Scott Morrison has said overseas, he needs to let that judicial process play out. The UK has given assurances that they wouldn't extradite him to a country that he would face the death penalty in, and the US has assured that he wouldn't face that if he was extradited there, so there's some comfort there. But as a journalist, I believe in the freedom of speech and the distribution of information and uncovering the truth. I want to be on his side, but nothing with Assange is clear cut. And if you believe everything else that the Ecuadorian embassy is saying, he was a terrible house guest. And for a nation that was providing him with support and a helping hand, having a cat and abusing internet access and phone call privileges and skating up and down the halls, not exactly the best way to keep a friend, I'm afraid.
No, not a good flatmate. Chris, Assange's lawyer says this is setting a dangerous precedent, that the Australian government should be defending him being an Australian citizen, and try to prevent his extradition from the UK. He's committed the offence in another country. Do you think he's at the mercy of the United States and its judicial system?
Unfortunately for him, he absolutely is at the mercy of the United States here. And when it comes to the matter of intervening in another country's extradition order and criminal charges, I agree with Davina Smith. Davina, unfortunately, this is a matter that's extremely political, and unfortunately for Assange, he's just not that popular. So, you know, with 35 days out from an election, would Scott Morrison really go out on a limb and defend Julian Assange, someone who, you know, as we've sort of heard, a lot of people are unsure how to feel about him. I think the matter of what he did at WikiLeaks, a lot of what was brought out was well worth putting into the public consciousness. Unfortunately, a lot of people still unsure about how they feel about him, what he was doing with unredacted documents. So, yeah, I think, unfortunately, he's on his own here.
OK, I'll have to move on quickly, guys. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have announced they're going to keep the arrival of their baby private so they can celebrate with family before making the happy news public. I do have a theory on this where I think the baby's already been born. Why would they put this thing out?
Great theory.
And increase the frenzy around it.
Yep.
So congratulations to the new mum and dad. That's purely speculative, by the way. But Davina, first to you, with little Rose, did you keep it a secret for a little bit?
Not a secret, but we didn't put it out there straight away. We told our parents, because heaven forbid if we didn't tell them that their first grandchild was born. It was probably about 24 hours before we let everybody else know. But I do remember my first thought after leaving the birth suite was, how on earth did Kate Middleton stand on those steps with a baby in her hands hours after giving birth when you've been through that? That is the last thing on earth you want to do. So high five. I don't disrespect Kate for what she did, but high five to Megan. I think you're doing the right thing. Just enjoy that bubble while it lasts, because it pops pretty quickly.
Chris, do you think it's fair enough they've asked for privacy, or given that they've got such high profiles, is it a case that it's in the public interest?
Yeah, it's absolutely fair enough. I wish them all the best. Trying to keep a secret from the entire world that everyone's pretty eager to find out about, I think they've got their work cut out for them. Also, note how many people are betting on this sort of stuff. The time of day, the gender of the nanny, all these sorts of things. So, yeah, a lot of people very interested. I think they've got their work cut out, but best of luck to them, yeah.
You feel happy for them, don't you? But at the same time, you're like, damn it, I want to know if it's a boy or a girl.
Yeah.
Yes.
They're keeping us all in suspense.
I also have a feeling that Harry's the Queen's favourite, which is why he's been able to move all these goalposts, don't you think?
He's also not the future king, so he can do whatever he wants.
Kind of, Guys, I don't think I was that surprised by this next one. A new survey has found 75% of Gen Zers believe they should be promoted within their first year on the job. For those of you wondering, which I've got to admit I had to Google this beforehand, Gen Zs.
Zeds
are people born in the mid-90s to mid-2000s, so they're in about their 20s at the moment. Chris, do you think you should get a raise and a promotion a year into the job?
Oh, definitely not. I mean, obviously you have to work for things, right? I mean, look, you should be trying to get a raise and a promotion, but that expectation should be all on yourself as opposed to the company that you work for. I mean, nobody should be shepherded through to the next level. You have to work really hard. I hope that Australians are a bit better here than they are in the US, which I think is where this research came from. I do hope that Aussies are a little bit harder working, a little bit less, expecting things handed to them than they are in the States.
Dominic?
I'm confused. Like, Chris, in your first year of work, did you not sit there after 12 months and go to a boss and say, OK, I've been here 12 months, can I get a pay rise? I know I did. I don't think it's just something for Gen Zers or Gen Z.
No, I was still making... Well, I'm still making mistakes, but I was still making mistakes 12 months into the job, so... I was too nervous about being fired. I was sort of just grateful they were keeping me on.
I just think within 12 months of being in any job that you're going to expect to be a career in, that you would be knocking on the door of your boss saying, hey, I've been here 12 months, any feedback, any advice, what extra responsibilities can I take on? I'm moving up in the ranks, I'm getting more experienced. I don't think it's unreasonable to be asking for a pay rise. I think Gen Zers, if that's what they're called, it's the worst name, are getting a bad rap. That said, they're all after our job, so maybe I should be not defending at all.
And guys, finally, Married at First Sight contestant Sam Ball has issued a grovelling apology for his behaviour on the show, which was nothing short of appalling, I reckon. He was manipulative, awful to his wife Elizabeth, saying on their wedding day that he'd never dated girls as big as her, and also had an affair to top it all off. Take a listen.
Look, I'm sorry if I've offended anyone, male or female, that's watched the show. I'm disgusted and ashamed the way I acted and treated other people. I made a lot of mistakes and I'm going to be a better person for that. Moving forward, I'm looking forward to this YouTube showing you the real me, not the edited version. And yeah, happy to be back to reality and hope to see you all in the near future.
Chris, you look like a diehard MAFS fan. Do you buy it?
Thank you. Thanks for noticing. Look, I don't buy it. I think it's pretty lame. I think he's obviously just promoting his YouTube channel, right? I mean, why not? This is trying to milk it for all it's worth. Good luck to him, I guess.
Short and sweet. Clearly he doesn't watch MAFS. He doesn't have much input to that. Davina, do you think he's redeemed himself in this post?
The thought is there. I also agree with Chris that the thought is there that he's trying to milk that extra 15 minutes of fame, and he's got a YouTube channel that he's just announced and he's hoping to get subscribers. The people I'm really hoping he's apologised to are the women that he deeply offended and hurt, and we saw in the finale episodes across Sunday and Monday night. They're two women who were really, really broken by comments about one of them about their bodies, the other one about whether they were or they weren't having a future together. So if he really is genuine about being sorry, I mean, the public, we all move on, but I hope those women actually got an apology as well.
Chris, I guess the problem with shows like this is, you know, people get their 15 minutes of fame and then they are trying to prolong it. Do you think that's what this guy's trying to do? He's obviously wanting to spruik his YouTube video.
Absolutely. I understand this guy's a tradie. It seems like he'd much rather be making YouTube videos that involve him running through the streets in a dinosaur costume. I think that was one of the ones that
promoted. That's what he's promoting. What the?
Yeah, so if that's, you know, if that's how he wants to kind of try to make a living in the future, I think, geez, good luck. But, I mean, I don't think I'll be tuning in.
I'm just going to have to cut you off there, Chris. Sorry, I know you want to talk about this all day. Guys, thanks for joining me and thanks for joining us.